A strong appeal for that mystery. I know you know, 'cause I feel, 'cause I feel you. I won't say why we met, I won't say why we met. It sounds too loud, it sounds too loud. I know you know, I know you know. 'Cause I feel you, I know. And love is calling us for sure. There's no reward.
What is your name?
Walter. We are Walter.
There are multiple universes here, right? And there is a tower that is basically like the vortex, called a magnet, that's holding the universe together. Walter, myself, the Man in Black, wants to bring that tower down, has been trying to bring that tower down. How do you bring it down? You find these young children that have very pure hearts and pure minds, what we call a shine. If their concentration is right, that is the power that can bring down the tower. Now, I've had it crumble, and I've had rocks fall off of it, and it's wavered like earthquakes, but I haven't brought it down yet.
So, what kind of crazy are you?
You have to promise not to get angry.
Why would I get angry?
Because you're going to hell.
Tell me something I don't know.
Heaven or hell? People don't find out where they're headed until they die. But I know where everyone's going. Because I'm the one who makes the decision.
Heaven,
heaven, hell.
Lobby looks good.
The lobby floor is highest on my list of pre-man nay duty, so I always make sure to spend a little extra.
That's Kendall, definitely heaven. If only I could figure out how to talk to her.
Hi.
Bill, just make the judgment, yes or no, up or down, heaven or hell.
But I can't.
You judge everyone.
Everyone living.
She's beautiful.
No way.
Talk to her and I will.
I don't think you have the balls.
I've got plenty of balls.
What's going on?
Maybe if there's some free time after all the matinee start, I can buy you some junior mints or something, but you wouldn't have to eat them with me. They'd be a gift.
Maybe after the matinee start, I can buy you some junior mints or something.
To my professional opinion, you're beyond fixing.
Walter can't get the girl of his dreams, really. What chance does true love have in this world?
Hey, tell me to just shut up if I'm crying or anything, but the past couple days, you've seemed a little off.
I really need to start getting ready now.
As soon as I'm done hugging you.
Do you know why I'm here?
Do you?
You're all going to hell.
You're looking a bit off. Not that you were ever a picture of on.
Hello, son.
He lied to me.
He told me that I could heal the problems of this world. But his bringing me back was never about fixing this universe. It was about destroying yours.
Part of a weapon that could destroy the other side. Have you activated that weapon?
We destroy their world to save ours. Now I am become death, the destroyer of the world.
How do you want to send back their Olivia, alive or dead?
They're gonna kill me. They're gonna cut out my brain and study it.
If you activated the machine on your side, you were going to use it to destroy this universe. I only acted in self-defense.
You'll experience loss the way I did. You destroyed my universe, son. And I'm going to destroy yours. You know, Peter, if I was really there, I might not be able to resist killing you.
Let's start by killing someone you love.
Walter! Are you all right? I thought I heard you shouting a minute ago. Walter! What's all the noise in here?
Noise, Mrs. Swickett? What noise?
Don't tell me I didn't hear a racket. Are you sure you're all alone?
I'm always alone, Mrs. Swickett. Yeah.
Walter, have you been talking to yourself again?
Well, I guess maybe I have, Mrs. Swickett. Somebody's got to.
Walter, you know, what you need is a girl. But she doesn't have to be pretty. Just so long as she takes good care of you.
Well, I can take real good care of myself, Mrs. Swickett.
Yeah, I can see that. Look at this pad. It's terrible. When did you ever clean it up? And when did you change these sheets last? They look like they're alive.
Mrs. Swickett, I gotta meet some friends in a little while, and I gotta take a shower.
Well, you know, why don't you clean up?
If you don't mind.
Stuff.
Oh, please,
what's
Mrs.
the matter?
Swickett. Hurt you, Lou. But if you'd have shot me, you'd be mopping up my blood now. I can't help it if I got scared and hit you. I didn't mean it. It's crazy. It's crazy. I didn't know you had it in you, Walter. How'd you do it? Well, I just took some clay and fixed it up. Go home and make something, Walter. Make another cat. But I haven't got another cat.
Look, you two guys are just... guys, okay? Mr. White, he's the devil. You know, he is smarter than you. He is luckier than you. Whatever you think's supposed to happen, I'm telling you, the exact reverse opposite of that is gonna happen, okay?
Jack, I'm sure you're bothered by what you're seeing. Just relax.
Just relax. Because I don't want to know anything.
Then you're trying to eat my face off. Or take over my body. You're going to be very sorry, mister. You're going to be very sorry, mister. You're going to be very sorry, mister.
Face feeding, Jack? Face feeding? I've never heard of that. Is that some sort of delicacy?
No. Forget I ever mentioned it.
You sure I shouldn't cry?
I'm positive.
Jack is okay, right? Jack is okay.
Friend! That's right. Friend! 100%. I'm your friend. That's all I want to be. I want to be your friend.
I do owe you an explanation.
No, you don't owe me anything.
Of course we're going to pay you for the boat. We're honest.
Well, of course you're honest. I accuse you of being dishonest.
Jack, sit down. Jack, I want you to listen to me very carefully.
We're Antarians. We're
Antarians. We're Antarians.
We're
Antarians.
Yeah, that's not pretty much big. Yeah,
about 100 centuries ago, we had about 100 centuries under. About 100 centuries under.
I think I'm better off not knowing.
And we were able to evacuate everyone except for my brother. And now we've come back for that.
No, I thought I'd been around. Nothing like this has ever happened before.
You could turn us in. Or perhaps we could do something else. But believe me, Jack, we will still get our friends back. And the only thing that would happen is we'd end up renting someone else's
boat. There's a man from the EPA here to see you. He's waiting in your office.
What do you want?
I don't know.
Can I help you? I'm Walter Peck. I represent the Environmental Protection Agency. Are you Peter Beckman?
Dr. Beckman.
I see. And now you catch ghosts.
There's something very strange about that man.
And where do you put these ghosts?
Listen, I'm usually very psychic, and I have a terrible feeling that something awful's gonna happen to you.
And may I see?
Yes.
We were right, Ray.
What?
Let's go.
What? Why is this closed?
What is that?
Shut it.
Lied to me. He told me that I could heal the problems of this world.
But his bringing me back was never about fixing this universe. It was about destroying yours.
Part of a weapon that could destroy the other side. Have you activated that weapon?
We destroyed their world to save ours. Now I am become death. The destroyer.
How do you want to send back their Olivia, alive or dead?
They're gonna kill me. They're gonna cut out my brain and study it.
You activated the machine on your side. You were going to use it to destroy this universe. I only acted in self-defense.
You will experience loss the way I did. You destroyed my universe, son. And I'm going to destroy yours. You know, Peter, if I was really there, I might not be able to resist killing you.
Let's start by killing someone you love.
Dear friends, come forward, friends. Step forward. I bring you a message. A message few of you will be able to believe. A message of great importance. A message I alone was able to read in the fires of the universe. But be not afraid, my friends. I also bring you the means with which to save yourselves.
Save us from what?
From the end of the world, friend. Which I don't expect you to believe. But the rest of you, those who want to be alive tomorrow morning, I will tell you tonight. Remember that. Bring your friends here. I'll tell you tonight so that you will be able to prepare.
What are you selling, Mr. Snake Oil?
The world will come to a flaming end at midnight tonight. Without my help and knowledge, every one of you will be dead.
To remain in town for long?
Well, I understand I have until midnight.
And you heard?
Yeah, I heard. Your name is Trump?
Dr. Waldo Trump.
D-U-M-C-S-S-R.
Oh, that's a whole bunch of letters.
Just a few of the degrees that have been conferred on me.
Would you mind running through them again for me?
D-U is Doctor of Universe. M-C, Master of Cometry. S-S-R, Student of Stellar Reactions.
Foreign contaminant. Foreign contaminant. Foreign contaminant.
So, what kind of crazy are you?
You have to promise not to get angry.
Why would I get angry?
Because you're going to hell.
Tell me something I don't know.
Heaven or hell? People don't find out where they're headed until they die. But I know where everyone's going. Because I'm the one who makes the decision.
Heaven,
heaven, hell.
Lobby looks good.
The lobby floor is highest on my list of pre-matinee duty, so I always make sure to spend a little extra.
That's Kendall. Definitely heaven. If only I could figure out how to talk to her.
Hi.
Bill, just make the judgment. Yes or no, up or down, heaven or hell.
But I can't.
You judge everyone.
Everyone living.
She's beautiful.
No way.
Talk to her and I will.
I don't think you have the balls.
I got plenty of balls.
What's going on?
Maybe if there's some free time after all the matinee start, I can buy you some junior mints or something. But you wouldn't have to eat them with me. They'd be a gift.
Maybe after the matinee start, I can buy you some junior mints or something.
It's my professional opinion. You're beyond fixing.
Walter can't get the girl of his dreams, really. What chance does true love have in this world?
Hey, tell me to just shut up if I'm crying or anything, but the past couple days you've seemed a little off.
I really need to start getting ready now.
As soon as I'm done hugging you.
Do you know why I'm here?
Do you?
You're all going to hell.
You're looking a bit off. Not that you were ever a picture of on.
I'm glad to sit here at the right hand of Satan. I'm glad to sit here at the right hand of Satan.
Walter Cronkite, we are proud to present to you this amethyst geode.
the game?
Oh, I told him if it was during league play.
What's during league play?
Life does not stop and start at your convenience, you miserable piece of shit.
I figure...
What's wrong with Walter, dude?
I figure it's easy money, you know. It's all pretty harmless. She probably kidnapped herself.
Huh?
Oh.
What do you mean, dude?
Rug peers did not do this. Look at it. A young trophy wife marries this guy for his money. She figures he isn't giving her enough, you know. She owes money all over town.
Fucking...
It's all goddamn fake, man. It's like Lenin said. You look for the person who will benefit and, you know...
I am the walrus?
You know, you'll, well, you know what I'm trying to say?
I am the walrus.
That fucking bitch.
Oh, yeah.
I am the walrus.
That's shut the fuck up, Donnie. V.I. Lenin. Vladimir Ilyich Ulyanov.
What the fuck is he talking about?
Fucking exactly what happened. Those... That makes me fucking sick.
Well, what do you care, Walter?
Those rich fucks. This whole fucking thing. I did not watch my buddies die face down in the muck so that this fucking strumpet, this
Walter,
fucking whore,
I don't see any
could waltz around
with Vietnam, man.
Well, there isn't a literal connection,
no, Walter,
dude.
Face it. There isn't any connection. You're wrong.
Have it your way. But my point is... My point
is...
Are
you ready to be fucked, man? I see you roll your way into the semis. Dios mio, man. Liam and me, we're gonna fuck you up.
Yeah, well, you know, that's just like your opinion, man.
Let me tell you something, Pandeo. You pull any of your crazy shit with us, you flash a piece out on the lanes, I'll take it away from you and stick it up your ass and pull the fucking trigger till it goes click.
Jesus.
You said it, man. Nobody fucks with the Jesus.
Eight-year-olds, dude.
We just sort of base our stories on nature, and out of it does come something that's of educational value, but I'm not labeling anything as educational. It's all entertainment. But I mean, people can... be educated and still be entertained.